welcome to Saliwal Production. In our video today, we are going to show you how to calculate an accurate and reliable GPA using Microsoft Excel. In all tertiary institutions, GPA has always been the most trending story for students at the beginning of every trimester. Students always complain, "My GPA fell from this to that and I don't understand." In this video, we are going to provide you with the solution to calculating your GPA using Microsoft Excel. So sit back, relax, and follow the tutorial. If you like the video and find it helpful, don't forget to click on the red button below to get updates of our videos.
After launching Microsoft Excel, you need to design our template. In this case, our template would include the name of the institution. The next faculty. Department. Okay, so here we indicate the year and trimester. So we have year one, trimester one. Then we have the credit hours, the grade included in GPA. Trimester GPA and cumulative GPA. Okay, we have the courses for the first trimester, IBS 101, IBS 103, IBS 107, ESB 101, ESB 103, ESB 105 and GEN 107. Now, credit hours, this is 3, 3, 3, ESB 2, 2, 2, and 2. So the student had A plus for IBS, B plus, B, B, A, C, and D plus. So these are the information for the student for year one, trimester one. Now, let's do this. Merge and center. Bring it to the center. We turn it vertical. Then area black. Wrap. Now we copy this. Paste it here. And we change this to 2. That's trimester 2. Now, trimester 2, the course codes, we have ESB 102, ESB 104, ESB 106, FAA 104, FAA 102, GEN 102, and IBS 102. Now the credit hours, we have 3, 3, 3, 2, 2, 2, 2. Now the grade letters, we have A, B plus, we have B, A, 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 and then B. Now we go to the third trimester, we copy this, we paste it here. Now the third trimester, we change this to 3. Just make it trimester. So we have FPP 120, credit hours 6, then the letter grade A. Okay, so now we are finished with the models. Now we are going to begin with the real GPA calculation. To do the real GPA calculation, you need to first spell out the grade and grade point equivalent. We have the grade and grade points, A plus A, B plus B, C plus C, D plus D, and F. These are the grid letters. Now we have their equivalent. A plus is 5, 4.5, 4, 3.5, 3, 2.5, 2, 1.5, and 0. Okay, now with the included in GPA, we are going to indicate what to include in the calculation of the GPA and what not to include. We just type yes, then we copy it and paste it. Good. So we fill it yes. So this means that whatever is here should be accepted in the GPA calculation. We do the same thing here and then the same thing here. Now, before we go into the calculation of the trimester GPA, we need another two columns. That is the credit column and the grade points. Okay, so now we are going to determine the credit hours to be used in relation to these credit hours. And then the equivalence of these letters, that is the grade, in the grade point. So to do that, we use the if function. Our equal sign, if included in GPA is a yes, then we relate it to the credit hour. But if it is a no, or if otherwise, it should be zero. It is going to now coordinate what should be included in the GPA and the credit hours. We now apply this to the rest of the cell. Now we go to the calculation of the grade point. We are going to still use the if function. We say if included in GPA is a yes. Now we are going to use another function here called the VLOOKUP. So you type VLOOKUP. Now look up for A plus in these two columns. How many columns have we picked? Two. This should be false. You open bracket and close. Then you close the VLOOKUP bracket and then if otherwise, zero. Now we multiply this by the credit hour. This. You enter. Now it has calculated the credit, the grade point for you. So you apply this grade point to the rest. Now we are going to copy the same thing here and then paste it in the next trimester. Then we copy this here and paste it in the last trimester. So now we have our credits and then the grade point. The credits and their equivalent grade point is what we are going to use to do the calculation of the trimester GPA. The formula for calculating the trimester GPA is the sum of the individual grade point multiplied by individual credit hours divided by the total credit hours. So we are going to take the formula, our equal sign, sum of individual grade point multiplied by individual credit hours, then we close, divided by total, that is sum of credit hours, then we close. So this gives us the trimester GPA. Now the first trimester GPA is equivalent to the cumulative GPA. So we are going to copy the same thing here and paste it in the cumulative GPA. So we copy the formula and paste it here. So this should be centered. Now you realize that the trimester GPA has a lot of decimal attached to it. Now we round it up to two decimal places. Round up to two decimal places. Two. Close bracket. That is it. So this is to two decimal places. We do the same to this. To two decimal places. That is it. So this is our first trimester GPA and then our first trimester cumulative GPA. Now we do the same here. Now we copy this and paste it here. We do the same thing here. Now with the second trimester cumulative GPA, we copy the first trimester cumulative GPA and paste it in the second trimester column. You realize that they are the same. It is applying the same formula of for this to this. So now we expand the coverage. You see, when you double click on it, it will tell you the coverage, the number of cells it is covering. So we have to extend this number of cells to include the first trimester grade point and the first trimester credit. So now the first trimester grade point starts with J6. So we expand it to J6. Now the second trimester is going to expand to I6. So we have I6. Now the total credit hours is also going to expand to I6. So we have I6. Then we enter. You see that it has calculated the CGPA for us here. Now it is the same thing we are going to do for the final trimester. That is trimester C. So we copy this, then we paste it here. You realize that the trimester C is outrageous. That is because the range of coverage is not yet set. So we double click on it, then you take the range that you want it to cover. It has to cover from the first trimester, the beginning of first trimester, up to the third trimester. So now we change this to J6. Then we change this also to I6. Then the cell here is also extended to I6. It is set. It is giving us the correct GPA. So this here represents the CGPA for the students at the end of the first year. This is going to be carried to the next year for GPA calculations. Now we have to format ourselves. So we hide these three cells. So you right click and you come to hide. So this is all we have for you for GPA calculation. If you like this video and you find it helpful, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more videos from Saliwal Production. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.